In the last video, I applied this worn and aged graffiti to the sides of the boxcar using the hairspray technique. In this video, I'm going to use stencils and airbrushing to apply this Scale Model Medic initial graffiti to the side of the model. Before I do that, I need to finish off the undercoat for the weathering on the ends. I don't know what this does here, I assume it connects the boxcars, but I'm going to weather the rest of this area and leave that alone because I don't know how the weathering is going to affect it. Using MIG thinner for washes and some burnt umber oil paint, I'm going to mix up quite a thick wash and I'm going to apply that generously into all that detail on the end of the boxcar. All of these panel lines are going to get a thick application of the wash and I'm going to let it run in there and apply some shadow and dirt into those recessed areas. When that's dried, you can see that it's quite streaky and it's pooled in a few areas. So I'm going to use a brush moistened with thinners and then using vertical strokes, just remove the excess. This will kill two birds with one stone as it allows me to clean up the wash but also add some rain streaking. To get rid of any stubborn areas, I'm going to use a cotton bud which has been moistened in the thinners. That area has been mostly cleaned off, leaving some grime in the recesses, and I can add more weathering to that later. This is the side of the model that's going to get the graffiti, and as with the previous video, I've actually given it a coat of hairspray before I go any further. If anything goes wrong, I can always apply water and remove the paint that I've added and start again. With the boxcar ready, I designed and printed out my graffiti image in a variety of sizes so I could match them to the actual boxcar and see which size was best. These are going to be used to create the templates. First by using a very thick styrene stock underneath the whole lot as a kind of cutting mat, on top of which I'm using very thin styrene stock to create the actual stencils themselves. I'll tape this down. I'll then place the graffiti image over the top and then cut through and hopefully be left with a perfect stencil. First, I'll just tape the thin styrene down to the top of the cutting board and then after selecting the correct size, tape down the graffiti image itself. When taping the graffiti image down, it's important to remember that this cannot move during the cutting procedure or it will ruin what you're trying to achieve. With everything in place, it's time to cut. Always use a nice new X-Acto blade when you're attempting this kind of work. A blunt blade won't lead to a clean cut and your templates will basically be ruined. As you can see, it worked perfectly and there is my overall outside edge template. Next up, I'm going to use this inside line as my cut and I'm going to create these three letter templates to spray inside. And now it's time for a test run. Using the old cutting board, I'm going to give the airbrush a quick run out and just see if the whole thing's worked out by spraying the first of black through the main overall outline template. And then I'm going to try and fill the lot in using white first as a backing for the colour over the top. And then I'll spray the colours as well and do the rest with the brush. I'll show you a little more later on how I lined up the letters, but for now this test run will just let me know whether the templates have actually worked. And as you can see, I've got a nice little bit of a replication there. I'll just colour this in now and then all being well, it's time to paint on the actual model. I plan to use a brush to do the touch-ups and hopefully it will come out just like this on the boxcar. Time for the real deal now, and securing the templates has never been more important, so I'm going to make sure these are well taped down to the boxcar before I begin. I'm going to be using Vallejo Air as usual and glaze medium to get it flowing through the airbrush nice and smooth, and I'll gradually build up a layer of black and block that whole area in. The reason I'm using a template to create the outside edge is because I want that nice fine line that I don't feel you can achieve with just normal brush painting. I remove the template while the paint's still wet to avoid anything sticking down and potentially peeling off. And then I'll run some matte varnish over the top just to seal everything in. I mentioned earlier about positioning the letters. This is how I do it. I place the graffiti image on, line it up, and then secure the template down with the tape. This is critical, so you have to be very careful. But once it's in place and the tape's been pressed down, the template will remain in situ, whereas the actual graffiti image used to line up just pops right out. And now the template's ready to use, after being fastened down securely with tape, of course. I'm now spraying a mixture of white Vallejo air and glaze medium, and again I'm going to remove while the paint is wet to avoid the template sticking down and chipping the paint away. Happy with that so far. I'm going to repeat the process again once the paint is dry, put the graffiti image on, line it up, then use that image to position the template before sticking the tape down to hold it in place and removing the graffiti image so that I can carry on with the painting procedure. Another light coat of white. It's a bit more important with the white that you get perfect coverage, as it's the undercoat for the colours which are being applied later on. So far so good. Only one letter to undercoat now and I can start with the colours. I'm going to be using red and yellow paint, mixed 50-50 for an orange, then red on the top and yellow on the bottom. There's no need for the graffiti image now. I can use the white outline to line up my template, and then I'm going to spray the colour directly across the middle with the orange. It's coming to life already. I'm not going to worry about those white lines on the edge of the letters. I can touch those up with the brush. Now I'm going to go in with the yellow across the bottom of the letters and blend that into the orange. Again, there's a little mess at the bottom, but I'm not going to worry about that because I can touch that up with the brush. Just the red remaining. With everything dry, it's just a case of dropping the template over the top yet again and then applying the red paint into the top. Red's a very strong pigment in the Vallejo Air range and it will easily cover over light colours like yellow and orange, so it pays to be very careful with a colour such as this. That's why the paint that I'm adding is such a fine layer. It's better to build up little and often then accidentally slosh too much over the top and potentially ruin everything that I've done so far. I don't mind taking my time for something like this because one mistake could ruin the whole thing, so I'll be very patient while I'm applying this layer of colour. A very fine nozzle on your airbrush is essential for detail work such as this. And finally, there's just the S to do, and as I lift the template off, you can see how that really pops right off the model. It's time for some cleanup now, and I'm going to use a very, very fine brush and some Vallejo Air black paint to tidy up those edges. I know that most people don't think that the Air series of Vallejo paints is suitable for brush painting, but I like it because it's so runny and fine, you can build up a very smooth coverage with a few coats. I'm going to go around the lettering now and take away any overspray that got under the template or any white lines that I don't want to remain on the final piece. One slip here would undo everything, so it pays to have a steady hand and a lot of patience. The top of the M was missing from my template, so I'm going to freehand this in. I'm now going to use the Vallejo Air White to add the little white bubbles which you can see here at the bottom of the graffiti image. These are just simple round dots painted in with absolute care. I don't want to overdo it, and I certainly don't want to slip up and leave white lines all over the model. So I'm just being very delicate and adding in these tiny little details. Highlights such as this you can only do with the brush really. The airbrush has got no business here. You wouldn't be able to cut the template small enough to do this kind of thing anyway. Time for the darker highlights now on the top of the letters. Using the Vallejo Air Red and a bit of black, I've mixed up a nice dark crimson colour, and I'm going to repeat the dotting process at the top and just add the little dark bubbles in. Only the stars to add in now. I'm going to paint those in freehand as well once I've finished adding the bubbles. And sadly, I've lost the footage of painting the stars on, so I'm afraid I'm just going to have to show you the finished result, which is here. And there's the graffiti added from start to finish on the side of this boxcar. And I think it's actually come out pretty good, and I'm well happy with the result. Thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to check out my page on Facebook. Just search for Scale Model Medic and then hit the like button.